King can't find anybody. Now goes to Debo. Debo going to be trapped in the corner. Remy Debo in trouble. Able to get it to Williams. Williams is trapped. Now to Adrian. Adrian, one more skip pass to Harris. Harris spins baseline. Gets in the lane and somehow gets it to go. You talked about that improved strength. How about that move?
Nice move. Nice spin move on the baseline. And that was a big basket. West Virginia really was kind of stale on that offensive possession. It had not been good. Got it to Harris, and he was able to create something.
Aaron Harris one more time. Look at him splitting the double team. He talked about that improved strength and had just enough of it to get that ball up on the glass and in.
Andy Kettler, the strength coach, sits over and grins every time he sees a basket go in like that. Those guys are there in the morning, early, and in the afternoons pumping those weights, and it pays off in those positions.
18 points for Aaron Harris, and make it 19. And the lead back up to 13, matching the largest of the game for West Virginia.
Well, West Virginia's been there a number of times. Mount St. Mary's has always been able to answer.
Prescott to Norfleet. Norfleet drives in trouble, and they're going to get him for a walk, I believe.
Right. Yes. Good help defense. Norfleet a little out of control. I think he initially wanted to go all the way to the basket, saw that he was cut off, tried to get a pass out, and traveled in the process.
Quick correction, the largest lead was 14 for West Virginia. They've been at 13 several times.
A number of times, yes.
They're at 13 now, 67-54. Timeout, Jamin Christian and his coaches talking things over. Bob Huggins has his team assembled out on the floor. And if you're Jamin Christian, I think you're beginning to feel this slip away from you a little bit. If you're going to make a run, they really haven't been able to make a run, Warren, have they?
No, not to cut it down to where, you know, you felt like one more basket and we're right there. I think, again, you know, hindsight is 50-50. He probably would have called a timeout to get a good set before that. Norfleet had been doing a good job, but he was certainly out of control right now. He wants to set this defense and get his troops back together to say, we've got to down. Time's coming down. We've got to make good possessions here.
Norfleet, 14.7 assists, has been the leader. As for the young players of the Mountaineers, what is it like to play for legendary coach Bob Huggins? Here's what they had to say.
He will push you to the limit every single day. There's not a day that he won't push you. So when you really got that message, that's when you get better. That's when everyone bounced back.
He's a lunch pail type of coach, blue collar, won't accept anything but your best effort.
That's the way he was as a player for the Mountaineers, correct? You played with him here,
goodness,
a captain.
Yes.
And
hard nose.
Bob Huggins, an illustrious career, and he could move into 18th on the all-time wins list, tied with Ray Meyer, who most people will remember as the DePaul coach, and closing in on some other big names like John Chaney at Temple, Jerry Tarkanian, and Norm Stewart at Missouri. Some illustrious, illustrious names on that list, and Bob Huggins, well, you put him right in there, and he just fits right in, doesn't
he? Certainly does. Mount St. Mary's with that pressure. West Virginia's guards doing a nice job keeping good spacing. Now, Mount St. Mary's is in this zone. Even though West Virginia didn't get a lot of movement the last time down, this clock is running. Shot might have been a little quick by Debo just now.
Norfleet kicks up, and boy, great closeout by Debo on the defensive end. Now Staten comes up and is able to score. Boy, Debo came out of nowhere, and whack, realized he was going to get it rejected, tried to pass it away. So maybe too quick on the offensive zone, but hustle back
turned
on the defensive
back. That's
end.
That's exactly right, and Bob Huggins can handle that. Offensively, it's going to take Debo a while to get in rhythm, but, you know, defensively, Bob wants to see that hustle, and that's what he got out of it.
Well, lead is at 15, largest of the game. Whack just can't get one to go. Batted around and chased down in the corner by Harris. So West Virginia beginning to put a stranglehold on this game.
Mount St. Mary's has to come out and go man-to-man. Now, I don't think they can sit back in the zone. They are man.
State. Able to get down to Adrian, kicks down to Williams. Williams goes to work. Right-handed spin, jump hook, no good. Rebound battled for, and Adrian doing a nice job coming over the top and battled Graves for the jump ball.
Jump ball, possession arrow to Mount St. Mary.
Yeah, Debo with that length. You know,
checking in for Mount St. Mary.
He's 6'7", he's got those long arms. Whack thought he was going to get a good look. As soon as he went up, Bob Huggins arguing that the possession arrow should be pointed toward West Virginia. officials going over to check.
Right. Unless we missed one. And he is correct, and it will be West Virginia basketball.
Possession arrow to West Virginia.
And Bob Huggins.
You know, that's one of the things.
Word and now a quick smile.
That's one of the things that your assistant coaches have to be alert to all the time. A lot of times the head coach doesn't see that, but one of the assistants is sitting there looking and recognizing that, yes, that should be West Virginia's basketball.
Off the inbound play, Staten will find the safety valve in Williams. Williams to Staten, they'll reset. Under 4 minutes remaining now in the second half. West Virginia up 15 in the season opener, the 2013-14 campaign. Staten, hesitation dribble to Debo. Debo, three-pointer, in and out. Rebound to Norfleet. Norfleet right down the middle of the lane, goes to the right hand, draws the foul, and will cut the lead to three with a chance to cut it to two when he goes to the free throw line. Norfleet keeping Jamie and Christian's team in it single-handedly. Beautiful move. Keep in mind, he is left-handed with a right-handed finish to lead 13 for WVU. West Virginia basketball is brought to you by WVDOT. Texting or talking on your cell phone while driving is illegal. If you don't use a hands-free device, it's not only against the law to have your phone in your hand while on the road, it's dangerous. Do your part to keep our roads safe. Turn it off, put it down, and just drive. Visit justdrivewv.com and take the Safe Driver Pledge. Season opener for two of the three teams nicknamed Mountaineers in the country, Appalachian State the other, as West Virginia, the Mountaineers, leading Mount St. Mary's, the Mountaineers, by 13 points. Norfleet at the line. Julian Norfleet has 16 points to lead the Mount. And here are the West Virginia leading scorers. Aaron Harris with 19, Juwan Staten 16, Brandon Watkins with 10 points in his West Virginia debut. Norfleet is trying to cut this lead back down to 12. And he's able to hit. And you would think that if you had a high-pressure defense and a quick-paced offense and you were Jamie and Christian, that this would be the time to employ.
Well, you're going to see it, and you have to get the mentality ready that you're going to be shooting some free throws, too. They're going to take some chances.
Here's Harris into Staten, and they will trap him in the corner.
Try to make Staten give that basketball up.
Harris gets it to Debo. Debo tries to go with a cut. Boy, that was lucky it was not turned over. Here's Adrian. Fakes a three-pointer. Drives into the basket. Nathan Adrian finishes. He joins the other three Mountaineers in double figures. Now four of them. Adrian and with 11.
That shooting ability of Adrian set that up. The defense came rushing out to try to set him, keep him from shooting a three, and he went right around and got a lane all the way to the rack.
And now Mount St. Mary's still trying to stay within their offense. Each possession is precious. Norfleet drives in. Boy, beautiful. Again, left-handed, soft right hand. We've seen him finish several times at the rim with that right hand.
Yeah, you can't cheat and overplay him just because he's left-handed.
Oh, nice hesitation move by Aaron Harris to break the pressure. And here's Staten now. And Staten, as you mentioned, with the fouls, will be fouled there by Rashad Wack. Will be one and one.
What you're going to have happen with guards anymore is guys that are smart like Staten and Harris and Norfleet. When they get by, they're going to curl their body into the defense and create that contact. You know, if the officials are going to be looking so much for that contact and call it on defense, the good players, the offensive players, are going to set up some ways to get in and make that contact happen.
State in front of the 1-1. And he missed it. So Norfleet with the rebound, and that's exactly what Mount St. Mary's was hoping for. Soaring high is Rashad Wack, who again has been a little out of whack here offensively for Mount St. Mary's. Norfleet going to work, splits the defenders, goes right to the basket, missed the layup. And Adrian with the rebound for West Virginia. Staten will push and cross the timeline and get West Virginia into their offense. Boy, Mount St. Mary's late in the game can ill afford things like that. And now the quick foul by Sam Prescott.
As good as Norfleet has been this evening, that might have been one of the easiest shots he's had.
Left-handed layup from a left-handed
without
shooter.
Without being contested.
Bob Huggins calls the timeout, and we talked about the upcoming schedule and the difficult upcoming schedule for Mount St. Mary's. Here's what is coming your way for West Virginia at Virginia Tech on Tuesday, part of a difficult non-conference schedule for West Virginia as well. Then they'll take on Duquesne and Georgia Southern, Presbyterian. All games you can see on Root Sports, certainly on Sunday and Thursday, then Saturday against Presbyterian. Tuesday taking on Old Dominion, November 26th. So West Virginia hoping to kind of string some victories here together following that 13-win season a year ago.
Yeah, that Georgia Southern Presbyterian, those two games are part of that Cancun Challenge. West Virginia will play two home site games here before going to Cancun to finish that tournament. Virginia Tech will certainly be sitting and waiting. West Virginia beating them by 1 point last year here in Morgantown. So you go down to Castle Coliseum in Blacksburg, it's always tough.
And talk about the key non-conference games beginning at Virginia Tech. We saw Missouri, Gonzaga on the list, Purdue. This is but Bob Huggins doesn't believe in ducking opposition. By the way, neither does Jamie and Christian. There's one more look at that schedule.
Yeah, that is a difficult non-conference schedule, but, you know, I think it bodes well if you can win a couple of those ball games. When it comes tournament time and that resume is sitting there, they take a good look at that.
Jamie and Christian really believe that it helped this team. They won their last nine games down the stretch in the regular season and the playoffs before losing in the NEC championship game. They won that, they would have gone to the tournament, and Wack just cannot find it. Williams challenge, shot off the mark. And another thing that bodes well, speaking of things that bode well, the fact that, you know, in games where we expect a lot of fouls, there's going to be a lot of free throws until teams get used to the new way things are going to be called. Staten, a 77% free throw shooter. Harris, 77% a year ago. Brown, 81%. Terry Henderson, when he gets back in, 77%. So if it does become a free throw shooting issue, West Virginia should be in pretty good stead. Staten has it blocked away by Wack, but Staten was fouled. So that could be a factor. Good experience, guard play, guys that can knock down free throws.
Right. You're going to have to be able to do it because you're going to be shooting a lot of them with this new call. And again, Staten taking a good blow right there, but able to get all the way to the basket. We've seen him do that numerous times tonight.
Staten sitting on 18 points. The lead sitting on 14 for West Virginia. 19 for Juwan Staten. Bob Huggins doing some coaching with Aaron Harris. 19, by the way, is a career high for Juwan Staten. So looking to establish a new career high.
You won't be seeing a lot of threes, I don't think, from West Virginia right now. You know, they'll take the layup, but they're going to try to eat the clock. Nathan Adrian, Big Gimpy.
Yep.
Didn't see what happened, he.
Remy Debo will check in for him. Looks like he's in some obvious discomfort. Staten, by the way, 8 for 10 from the free throw line. So,
with Nathan Adrian, You hope it's nothing. He had a broken foot last year in high school and had to sit out some significant time. You hope certainly it wouldn't be anything like that, but we'll just have to wait and see. Boy, there's another shot by Miller. Miller is one of those guys that doesn't matter when he comes in the ball game. He doesn't have to be heated up. He comes in ready to fire it up.
Well, and I think, you know, it's interesting that talking to Jamie and Christian, a very impressive young coach, earlier this week, he said, look, my guys have the green light. Anybody can come in and just fire away. That's what we do. We shoot three-pointers, and he recruits guys that play that way. He wants guys that will make the extra pass, make sure you get it to the you know, he doesn't – when you say mayhem, you think kind of Loyola Marymount, you know, just right. Firing things up willy-nilly. He wants to make sure his guys are getting a good look. But the first good look somebody has, he wants it up. He doesn't care who it is. But we saw a seven-footer, Danaher hitting a three-pointer.
Sure did. Well, I tell you what, he had a good teacher in Shaka Smart. And, you know, you could see a lot of Shaka Smart in him as he's coaching this ball game. And certain Smart at VCU has done a tremendous job.
No doubt about it. One of the great coaches in the country. Also coached, he began his coaching career at Emory and Henry. And he said they averaged 105 points per game. So he wants points up on the board. He wants that pace quick. But credit West Virginia's defense. They've made that difficult for Mount St. Mary's. They've also done a good job here offensively breaking this pressure. Staten crosses the timeline. Now we'll knife into traffic, and Danaher there to challenge. And Bob Huggins thought that was a foul. Three-pointer up the other way. No good, as again, Rashad Wack just cannot find it tonight. And now Staten will add to his career high. 22 points for Juwan Staten, and the Mountaineers' lead is at 15 as we're under a minute to go in the 2013-14 season opener.
West Virginia, no fouls, box out, rebound.
A long three-pointer by Norfleet off the mark. Boy, he's had such a strong game, but maybe running out of steam a little bit.
Prescott
will check back into the game. Shot clock is still on, 2.2 second differential.
As well as Krina
back into the game for Danaher. Bob Huggins still looking for explanations. Staten will take his time with this short differential between the game clock and the shot clock. West Virginia handily up 15. They're going to begin the season with a victory.
Mount St. Mary's not going to foul now. Just let it run down.
Harris looking up, checking the clock, and getting the count from the official. Let's see where the shot clock is. Aaron Harris sees the differential. Now we'll go to work. Aaron Harris driving to the basket, lays it up. No good as it rattles out. That will be the final shot of the game as West Virginia, the musket goes off in victory as West Virginia defeats Mount St. Mary's 77-62. Nice moment there between Bob Huggins, one of the great coaches in the game, and Jamie and Christian, a young man who has, yes, a bright future ahead of him. And your thoughts on what you saw from West Virginia tonight, Warren?
Well, another good solid effort. And again, Juwan Staten controlling the offense for the Mountaineers. Outside shooting again by Aaron Harris. Watkins with a good game inside. Yeah, good all around. Now, Huggins is going to find 1,000 things wrong, as he should, but a good solid win for West Virginia as a home opener.
And you can see Bob Huggins, he's going to be doing this all season long, moving up the coaching ladder, tying Ray Meyer for 18th all-time with career victory number 724. So the Mountaineers of West Virginia able to beat back the attack from the Mountaineers of Mount St. Mary's. Final score was 77-62 as they go to 1-0 on this young 2013-14 season. For Robbie Inzmikowski, Warren Baker, I'm Rob King. Thanks very much for watching West Virginia basketball.
Step out of the way.